No.
I'm Ant-Man.
I know. It wasn't my idea.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to this week's movie review of Ant-Man, starring Paul Rudd and Michael Douglas. The MCU's most relatable hero since Spider-Man has hit the big screen, and I for one couldn't be happier. In a world of gods, reality-destroying beings, and evil artificial intelligences, it's a nice change of pace seeing a hero who manages to be down-to-earth, who connects with the average person, while still living in such an over-the-top and interconnected world. Ant-Man harkens back to the early days of the MCU by being a tight and directed small film with a good sense of focus, much like the first Iron Man film. The film tells the story of Scott Lang, a struggling father trying to provide and prove himself to his daughter after a prison stint for burgling his former employee. At the same time, Scott's efforts and journey to redemption collide with Hank Pym, the original Ant-Man, and his daughter Hope Van Dyne, as they attempt to stop Pym's protege, Darren Cross, from duplicating Pym's shrinking formula in order to weaponize it and bring his suit, the Yellow Jacket, to life. Although some may argue that the film is a tad too direct and formulaic, causing it to be a generic origin tale, I would argue that its direct simplicity allows it to be a tighter, more focused film that not only changes things up in terms of MCU films, but also brings something slightly new to the table that distinguishes itself from all the other past films. It's a direct and compact film, like the first Iron Man, but still has enough grandiose elements to make the film its own thing, as well as standing out on its own. Tonally, the film has Edgar Wright's hands all over it, from the fast-paced editing and quick time cuts, witty dialogue, and humorous down-to-earth characters who are also lovable and incompetent fools. It's all found here, practically making this Wright and Joe Cornish's film, minus their names at the end of the credits. One has to wonder why Marvel wouldn't just let Wright take the film in the direction that he wanted to take it if they were just going to keep most of what he brought to the film in the first place. This can be marked as a minor weakness to the film that is reminiscent of the science fiction comedy Paul. It had so many elements of an Edgar Wright film that you could tell that he had his hands in it, but it's not quite his full-blown presentation, giving it a feeling of being so close yet so far away. It's almost as if Ant-Man is some kind of hollow version of an Edgar Wright film that could have been so much more glorious if he had only just stayed on the project to complete it. Most elements and technical presentation of the film follow through as solid. Pacing is good, as the film never has any extreme moments of downtime or overstimulating the viewer with too much chaos. Although it would have been nice for the film to focus a bit more on character development and dramatic moments. These moments are addressed, but it seems like they are touched upon as opposed to properly explored. I would have loved to see Lang interacting with his daughter a little more, in order to give us a greater sense of responsibility and bonding when she is in danger. This better establishes her as a character instead of a plot device for Lang's character. The same extends to the rest of the cast. It's not a horrible thing per se, but a minor and persistent gripe in the film. For example, Darren Cross feels betrayed by Pym, as he never took him on as his true student, and the Pym particles have altered his mind, making him a homicidal maniac. This is all direct and true to the character in the Ultimate line of the comics, where Yellowjacket is a villain and not the alter ego of Pym, and the formula does mess with the human mind. But to mention these things in passing and exploring them are two different things. While Cross's Yellow Jacket was fun and showed moments of glory, he did suffer from being underdeveloped. The material to have a truly engaging and tortured character was there, but the filmmakers opted to either cut it or not bother exploring it altogether, which hurt the final product. The well-rounded cast all did a solid job with their roles, with Michael Peña completely stealing the show with his comedic delight, brilliant timing, and a great sense of charisma. Praise must also go to the minor cast, and their characters whose banter and witty conversations were a highlight of the film. Had Edgar Wright stayed on this film, we might have seen more of this explored further and ended up with more memorable gags, such as Baskin-Robbins always knowing what you do. I also enjoyed how these goofy interactions all allow Ant-Man, by extension, look like an incompetent Avenger. And that's a good thing. Scott Lang is just your average Joe who has stumbled upon something great and doesn't quite know what to do with it. Does that remind you of anybody? He has bills, absurd daily troubles, can't find a job, can't catch a break, and his foolish friends only add to his humorous struggles. This comments on the daily woes of its viewers, as well as satirizing life in hilarious fashion. Truly an excellent commentary. action sequences also look great and are hilarious, and the film brilliantly spoofs the chaos found in films like Man of Steel or any Michael Bay movie without having that true sense of destruction where countless people die and is shrugged off as if nothing ever happened. The ability to change size also allows the film to have some hysterical moments and prop gags, giving the filmmakers a literal world of ideas and comedic gags to play with, which they fully take advantage of, and this is the most evident during the third act and final sequence of the film. Now, is this the next big thing or Guardians of the Galaxy? No, but its direct simplicity, excellent cast, witty elements left behind from its original production, and overall aesthetics, fight sequences, up to par CGI, and writing should be more than enough to hold down the casual audience and entertain most comic book and MCU fans despite its faults and issues from its difficult production. Ant-Man gets an 8.5 out of 10.